So here's a technique that comes in handy if you use the shuffle function in iTunes on your Mac, but you don't want the songs to shuffle in a completely random order. An example is when you have classical music albums. Typically, you have a piece that's divided into several tracks. For instance, here there's an album of all of Beethoven's 9 symphonies, and each symphony is broken up into several tracks. So you have 4 tracks for the first symphony, 4 for the second, etc. Now, if I were to hit shuffle, it would start shuffling all of this music here. And you can see it's doing symphony number 8 there. If I were to use the forward button, it would jump to 2, it would jump to 4. It would keep jumping around and playing different parts of different symphonies. I don't want that. I want it to play an entire symphony and then shuffle to another one. And there is a way to do that using a special data field called grouping. So I'm going to select the first track here and I'm going to use Command I to get info on it. And you can see here all the information about this track. Now grouping is right here underneath Composer, and grouping, you can put whatever you want in there. So, but you're going to want to use a name that makes sense. So I'm going to call it Beethoven and First in this case. And I'm going to hit OK, or I can go forward arrow to the next track and I could do the same thing. Let me go back and just copy and paste. I'm going to copy, I'm going to go forward, paste it in the next track, paste it the next one, paste it the next one. So all of the first 4 tracks are grouped as Beethoven First. I can do it for multiple tracks at the same time. So I can select by using the Shift key all 4 parts of Symphony No. 2, Command I, and I can type Beethoven Second and hit OK. Now all 4 of those are set. So I'm going to go ahead and set those for Symphonies 3 through 9 as well. So now I've set the grouping for all these tracks. The next thing I need to do is go under Controls to Shuffle. And you can see you have 3 choices here. Shuffle Songs, Albums, and Groupings. So I want to make sure I select Groupings there. And you can see that the checkmark moves to Groupings. Now when I hit the Shuffle button, it will jump right to the first track in a group. So there it's jumped to the first track in the 5th symphony. If I use the forward arrow now, it goes to the second track, the third track, and now another one will shuffle to another symphony, in this case Symphony number 2, and it goes through those tracks before it jumps to another random symphony and plays all of those in order. So that allows you to group together these songs. Now grouping works in conjunction with other things. So I've noticed that, for instance, when I tried to apply this to a playlist and had songs from different albums, it didn't work. I couldn't group 2 songs from 2 different albums together. But it works within an album to do it. It even works inside of playlists. So I can jump to this Beethoven Symphonies playlist, which has all the same songs in it. And if I hit Shuffle All here, I find that it will jump to the first track in Symphony number 5 and go through all of the ones of that symphony before jumping to another one, in this case 8, and then go through all of those. So it even works in playlists. So you can have several different albums in a playlist and then group together songs within each album and then expect those songs to stick together as long as the grouping and the album are the same. So very handy for classical music and for some other types of music as well. Other, you know, rock albums or soundtrack albums that have songs grouped together that you want to keep together when you shuffle.
Thank you.